Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. In another video, I derived the formula for the cosine of A plus B, in other words, the cosine of the sum of two angles, and we got cosine of A cosine B minus sine of A sine B. So using this identity, which was already derived, we're going to now derive the formula for the cosine of A minus B, the sine of A plus B, and the sine of A minus B. And we'll be using a couple other identities to do that. So let's start off with the cosine of A minus B. So what we want to do is think of that as the cosine of A plus a negative B. And that way I could use this formula up here, but in place of B, I'm going to plug in negative B. So I think we're going to run out of space. I'm going to go down the page. So I'll have the cosine of A, cosine of negative B, minus the sine of A, sine of negative B. Now, the other identities you need to know are the cosine of negative b is the same thing as the cosine of b, and the sine of negative b is negative the sine of b. So, in other words, the cosine of negative b actually is the same thing as the cosine of b, but the sine of negative b is actually negative the sine of b. That's because the cosine is an even function, whereas the sine is an odd function. And so we're almost there. So we have cosine A, cosine B, we have a negative, and we have a negative one over here. So that's going to be plus sine of A, sine of B. So the cosine of A minus B, after doing all this work, ends up being the cosine of A, cosine of B, plus the sine of A, sine of B. So you might notice for the cosine of A plus B, you've got the minus sign in the middle here, but for the cosine of A minus B, you have a plus sign, opposite signs. But other than that, they look exactly the same. Cos cos minus sine sine, or cos cos plus sine sine. All right, so that's the formula for the cosine of A minus B. The next identity we're going to derive is the sine of A plus B, but we'll be using some of these identities you see up here. The one I just went over, the cosine of negative A equals the cosine of A, and the sine of negative A equals negative the sine of A, but these other two as well. The cosine of 90 degrees minus x is the same as the sine of x. What those represent, the x and the 90 degrees minus x, are the two acute angles in a right triangle. So the sine of one of those acute angles is the cosine of the other one. So just so you get a little picture here, remember if this is x, this angle right here would be 90 degrees minus x. And so let's say these were labeled as A, B, and C. Notice that if you took the sine of x, you get a over c. That's the same thing as the cosine of 90 degrees minus x, which is also a over c. So that's these identities up here. And then, of course, the two we have already talked about, the cosine of a plus b and the cosine of a minus b. All right, so now we're going to go for it. So we've got, what's the sine of a plus b? Well, I'm going to use this identity right here. It says the sine of an angle is the same thing as the cosine of 90 minus the angle. But the angle, I don't have an x, I have an a plus b. So this becomes the cosine of 90 degrees minus this angle, a plus b. Okay? And I'm going to rewrite that by distributing my minus sign. So I have the cosine of 90 degrees minus a minus b. And I'm going to think of putting these first two terms together, 90 minus a, in the parentheses. So now it looks like the cosine of an angle minus another angle. And I'm going to use this identity right here. All right? So now we do that. That says it's going to be the cosine of the first angle. Well, The first angle this time is 90 degrees minus A. Okay. And we've got cosine of the second angle, which is B. And then we have plus the sine of the first angle, so sine of 90 degrees minus A, times the sine of the second angle, which happens to be B. But now I could simplify this cosine of 90 degrees minus A from the same formula. The cosine of 90 degrees minus x is just the sine of x, so the cosine of 90 degrees minus A is just the sine of A, cosine of B, and the sine of 90 degrees minus A, oops, I don't know why that happened, is going to be the cosine of A. Sorry, I'm having all sorts of stuff that never happens on a regular blackboard. Cosine of A, and I have that sine of B. And there we have the formula for the sine of A plus B. So I'm going to write that down. The sine of A plus B equals what you see up here. Sine of A, cosine of B, plus cosine of A, sine of B. All right, so now we have the cosine of A plus B, the cosine of A minus B, and the sine of A plus B. There's only one more to do. We'll now do the sine of A minus B using the same trick we did to get the cosine of A minus B. We'll just plug in a negative B in place of B. So let's go on to the last thing. So here's the formula we just derived. The sine of A plus B equals the sine of A cosine of B plus the cosine of A sine of B. So how are we going to do the sine of A minus B? We're going to think of that as the sine of A plus a negative B, and then we will replace B up here with a negative B. So here we go. We get the sine of A, the cosine of negative B, because we're plugging in negative B for B, plus the cosine of A, the sine of negative B. And remember, the cosine of negative B is the same thing as the cosine of B, because the cosine is an even function. And what's going to happen with this sine of negative B? You're going to be able to pull out a minus sign. That's the same as the negative the sine of B, so that's going to change that plus to a minus, minus the cosine of A, sine of B. All right, so that's the fourth one. So let's see what they all look like now. Here they are. Here are the four trig identities for the cosine and sum, cosine and sine of the sum or difference of two angles. So the way I remember it is for the cosine, whatever the sine, like positive or negative, plus or minus, inside the parentheses, it's the opposite sign over here, right? And for the sine of the sum, it's still a plus, and the sine of a difference, it stays a difference. Okay, and then I just remember cosine goes cos, cos, and then sine, sine. And for the sine, it goes the sine, cosine, and then the cosine, sine. And both times it goes AB, AB. But however you memorize it, you know, everybody has their own little ways of remembering formulas. But those are the formulas you need to do the cosine or sine of the sum or difference of an angle. Let's go ahead and just do an example now where we could use one of these in a problem. All right, so here are two right triangles. These are kind of basic ones. Hopefully you're familiar with the 3, 4, 5 right triangle and the 5, 12, 13 right triangle. So we have two angles, A and B, that you can see. We want the cosine of A plus B. So you can see it's probably a little bit less than 90 degrees, just looking at the picture, if you put those two angles next to each other. So what's a cosine of A plus B? Well, from the formula, it's going to be the cosine of A, cosine of B, minus the sine of A, sine of B. All right, so let's just look at the picture. What's the cosine of A? Well, that's 12 thirteenths. And what's the cosine of B? You got to look over here at B, and you're looking for its cosine. It's 4 fifths. Minus sine of A. Looking back over at A, the sine is 5 thirteenths. And the sine of B, looking at that picture, is 3 fifths. All right, so what does that give me? Well, you got to do your multiplication first. So 12 times 4 is 48, 13 times 5 is 65, minus. In the top here, I've got 15 over 65. So I have a common denominator. How convenient. So I subtract and I get 33 sixty-fifths. So that would be the cosine of A plus B. And if you put, drew a little picture of what A plus B looks like, maybe, it looks something like that. Maybe A plus B is about that big, and you sort of have to say, does that seem like a reasonable answer? Well, to me, like this looks like it's about half of this length here, right? If this was 33 and that was 65. So you should, if you want, you could look at a picture and see if your answer makes some sense. Okay, let's do the same problem. Not the same problem, but using the same triangles. Let's do the cosine of A plus B. I'm sorry, we did the cosine of A plus D. Let's do the cosine of A minus B. It looks exactly the same, except what's the only difference for the formulas? The only difference in the formula is this ends up being a plus sign. So the very last step's really the only place it's going to be different. This will be a plus sign, that'll be a plus sign, last one will be a plus sign. So in the end, we get 48 sixty-fifths plus 15 sixty-fifths. So our answer ends up being 63 sixty-fifths. So that would be the cosine of A minus B. And you can write down all those steps again, but hopefully it makes sense to you. The main difference here is at the end when I add the two fractions. And in both of these cases, the cosine and the sine is always less than one. So notice both of these, the numerator better be smaller than the denominator, unless of course for a triangle, right? For a right triangle, that's always got to be true. It's got to be between negative 1 and 1. All right, let's go ahead and do the sine of A plus B and the sine of A minus B. So put the video on pause and using the same two triangles, figure out the sine of A plus B and then the cosine. I'm sorry, do the sine of A plus B and then the sine of A minus B. All right, let's do the sine of A plus B first. So we look at the picture. What's the sine of A? You got to look at A and do the sine first. So that's 5/13. And multiply it by the cosine of B, and the cosine is 4/5. Plus, then the cosine of A, got to look it over at A over here, 12/13. And then the sine of B, oops, did I do this right? Yes, that's 3/5. Okay. Boy, you really have to be careful on here. You're looking at the right triangle and whether you're looking at the adjacent or the opposite sign, side for the sine of the cosine. All right, so what do we have here? We've got 20 sixty-fifths plus 36 sixty-fifths, and that's going to be 56 sixty-fifths. That's the sine of A plus B. Again, making sure that the sine is going to be less than 1. And notice this is almost the number 1 because if you add these two angles together, it's going to be almost at 90 degrees. And remember, the sine of 90 degrees is 1. So that looks like a reasonable answer. And let's do the last one, sine of A minus B. What's the only difference here? Since we just computed the sine of A plus B, we know everything's going to be the same except instead of this being a minus sign, a plus sign here, it'll be a minus sign. So our final answer, once we do those first two steps, will be subtracting. And that's, oops, don't know why I wrote 36 both times. All right, so we do 20 minus 36 is negative 16 sixty-fifths. All right, does that make sense that the sine would be negative? Well, look at B is a bigger angle than A. So if you do A minus B, you're going to get a negative angle. So it would end up being in quadrant 4 if you looked at that angle, and the sine is negative in quadrant 4. So there's an example using finding the cosine, sine, and sine of the sum and difference of two angles. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.